Today in Ultimate Epic Battle Simulator, we find out who the best unit is. Let's get into it. So today I thought we would do something a little different. We've been doing a lot of user suggested stuff and kind of focusing on like really cool battles. But I thought we need to find out who the best unit is. Now, obviously some of you have been watching probably know who that is. But we need to know who are the best units amongst the various different types of units in game, and the only way to do that is to have some epic battles. Now, I thought about doing it on Avalanche Canyon, but we'll do some on here. The main problem is that there's not a lot of room to work with. This side might be the best because there's no trees, but I thought we would test out some massive battles and find out who the best units are and exactly who comes out on top. First up, we have 10,000 footmen versus 10,000 Romans. Now, here's the thing with the Romans. The footmen have 220, I believe, double 200 health, and they have 110. But the Romans have more armor. And so I'm curious to know if that plays a difference. And so we're going to find out right now who is the best unit amongst the, the kind of the general fighters. Right, you'd say they're kind of like a generic general fighter, right? Because look at the, they both have 33 attack damage, so it could go either way. The Romans have already killed look at this, see what I'm saying? I'm telling you, I think it's all because of the armor. It's gotta be, right? It's gotta be the armor, it's gotta be the shields. So even though the Romans have less HP, it seems as though the footmen are no match, potentially. It'll be a lot interesting to see where this battle goes. I'm going to let them play out. 10,000 units. It's going to take a long time, if you can't tell. But it's going to be pretty... Dude, that is a cool looking... The one thing I like about the Romans and the footmen are that they're so colorful. They're so colorful. Look at them. Yeah, this is going to be quite the epic battle. And it's going to take a while, but I think it's going to be worth testing and finding out. We can always do smaller numbers, but what's the fun in that? This is Ultimate Epic Battle Simulator. We need some massive battles. The sun's starting to go down, and I think it's safe to say that the Romans are gonna probably win this battle. They have a commanding lead, and I think it all comes down to the armor and the shield. I was actually going to maybe give the Romans more units, but I don't think it's necessary. I think there's actual armor system in the game, and it seems to have a pretty big effect on the battles. I also need to try to figure out what other units to pit, because I'm thinking maybe the spearmen would be a better test against the footmen, because they have really low HP. And so I think I'm going to go ahead and call it for this battle. I'm just going to let it play out, but I mean, the difference is pretty substantial. I hope you guys agree with me, because I'm going to nuke them. I love the nukes. Yeah, so just so you see here, footmen, 200 health, 33 damage. And for the Romans, they have 110 and 33. So the spearmen, though, have 133. Maybe we should test the spearmen versus the Romans. Ooh. Although, I think the spearmen kind of stink. I don't think they're nearly as good, but I think we need to test that for sure. Spearmen versus the Romans. Where are the spearmen? Medieval? There they are. Yes, 10,000. 10,000. We must test. Oh, they're a weird, odd shape. We're going to have to fix this maybe, because we don't want them to... They're going to have some units missing here. We might have to bring them up a little bit. Here we go. Man, they're already on each other. Look at this. This is going to be interesting to see what happens here in the beginning. Who can attack faster? Oh, the spearmen's... Ooh. Looks like the Romans have met their match, potentially. Oh, yeah, look at this. That's substantially different already, just from the get-go. I don't think the results are going to be skewed by putting them that close. I'm not sure, but all I can say is that the Romans, I think, are getting brutally... Wow, look at the differences there. I didn't think the spearmen were this good, but I guess that range really plays a huge part in the actual battle. Holy smokes! Holy crap, you want to talk about a massive difference. Look at the enemies killed on the freaking spearmen side. Holy dude, they're just brutally destroying the Romans. You know, it'd be a good test for the spearmen are probably cavalry, because you think cavalry might die. I don't know. I'm just trying to think of like what units would be good against what, but I think it's safe to say the spearmen can easily destroy the Romans. Get nuked. Okay, so the cavalry units, I think, have longer swords. They have 600 HP, and they only do 65 damage. So I'm thinking they might be a pretty good test for the spearmen. The only problem is, I don't know how in the world I'm going to fit the necessary units in this area. That does not seem possible. So, oh my gosh, no way. So I might have to go to another map, and we might cut the number to 5,000. And let's go to World of Thieves. Yeah, we should be able to do it up in here. That was my thought. Or we might even do it down here, where there's even more room. I think this will be a pretty good battle right here. Once I get this set up. Here we go. This will be a good test. 5,000 cavalry versus 10,000 spearmen. Let the battle commence. The cavalry are pretty, like, massive. And so, look at that. They might actually do... And they run into the units. They don't make a wall. But look, the spearmen are still doing wonder... Oh, the cavalry's catching up. Oh, man. It seems they've met their match, perhaps. It's really close, though. Look at how close the numbers are. These guys are like really well matched. The spearmen are taking back a little bit. More cavalry coming in on the sides and stuff. Spearmen are taking the lead. Oh, man. The spearmen are... Wow, what the freaking Tron going on over here? What in the Tron? The spearmen are way better than I thought they were. I think the main match for the spearmen are going to be the Spartans. You know what I mean? We'll let this battle play out a little bit and see what happens. I think they're going to take a commanding lead here after a little bit, but I think the spearmen might meet their match against the Spartans, because the Spartans have shields, have spears, and they have way more HP than the spearmen do. Okay, so some time has passed, and it looks like the spearmen have... What in the world? What is this? Why? What's going on with this? If I use this as a thumbnail, you guys are going to claim clickbait. But I'm not. It's freaking Tron stuff going on. I don't know what. I don't know what's happening. Why is this occurring? But this is freaking awesome to see. This is like the blood from other things. But like, what's with the Tron shields? Anyway, I was going to maybe wait a little bit longer, but I think it's pretty safe to say that the spearmen are going to just win this battle, because they're already in such a commanding lead. And then once more of them... Oh, is it because I'm, like, kind of highlighting them? But these guys' shields are lit up. Yeah, once more of them die, obviously it's going to be a total defeat for the cavalry. So we're going to try spearmen versus the Spartans, and then I got an epic battle in mind, and it's going to be really freaking awesome. Get nuked! Yeah, nobody survives nukes. Except for one person. Alright, so here's the real challenge. Okay? Spearmen with 100 HP, 33 damage, versus the Spartans. Okay? First of all, look at the difference in damage. Look at the difference in health. So, I'm thinking we lower the amount from 10,000... to, let's just see if 5,000 can do it. I'm thinking they can, because here's the thing. The deal with the Spartans is that they have like a shield wall, and they actually have like a legitimate functioning wall, and they attack that way. And you can see them raise their shield, lower the shield and stuff. It's like what it's legitimately supposed to be in a phalanx. And so I think 5,000 is going to be able to overwhelm and look at the I tried to make the shapes relatively the same so they couldn't get one side couldn't get flanked, But even then, it doesn't really matter. So let's start this battle and see what the heck happens. I'm thinking the Spartans are going to do just fine. Just fine. And that is a sweet, sweet sight to see. Let's speed it up. Let's get it on. Oh, man. Oh, my gosh. See, it doesn't even matter. Doesn't even matter. I could do 3,000. And I think the Spartans would still overwhelm the Spearmen. Or any unit, for that fact. What a difference. What a difference that damage and stuff makes. I like that. I like that red, man. That's pretty cool. Okay, so yeah. That's an overwhelming difference. And it's because they have so much HP. So I'm thinking we lower that number even more. Maybe we do 2,500. Maybe we cut it in half even further. 2,500. Okay, can 2,500 Spartans defeat 10,000 Spearmen? No. Can 2,000 Spartans defeat 10,000 Spearmen? I think they definitely can. The Spartans are just one of the best. I think they're like probably short of a super unit. They might even be able to take out Golden Knights, to be honest. All right, here we go. Let it happen. Here we go. Speed it up. Watch the numbers. Even 2,000. The thing with the Spartans is that they don't get overwhelmed. They don't get flanked. Because they fight with the same mechanic with the shield wall at the sides too. So they can't die. They just can't die. The only way that the Spearmen are going to defeat the Spartans is if they kill it. I keep bumping the mic, I'm sorry. If they kill enough to where they can surround them, which I don't think is going to happen. It's getting pretty interesting now because there's only 700 Spartans remaining and 4,000 Spearmen still left alive. So I think maybe the sweet spot would be 2,500. But, I mean, this could go. This really could go either way. What's with the shields? I love it. I wish that they're like a futuristic unit. I think it's something to do with this valley, maybe. Or maybe he added some kind of effect that it doesn't look as bad during the night or something. I mean, they might be able to pull this out. They've got 3,000 left to go. Oh my gosh, they're losing numbers pretty quickly, though. Wow, this is just shows the power of the Spartans, though. It's just insane. The crazy thing is that for every 100 Spartans die, they kill 1,000 Spearmen. Just about. It's getting less and less as time goes on, but it's pretty freaking close. It's an insane difference. Oh, it's slowing down dramatically now. Oh, no. Yeah, 2,500 might have been the sweet spot. Dang it. I really wish I would have seen that happen and kind of had that perfect. The battle has not been going on that long, though. Yeah, we'll move on to the next thing. Because I've got a pretty epic battle in mind. There's 40 of them left. But look, these 30 guys are destroying so many Spearmen still. Oh, it's over. They're getting shanked from all sides. Wow. Look at that, though. 2,000 Spartans destroyed 8,300 Spearmen. That's pretty crazy. Legend has it that there is a unit in this game that is so overwhelmingly powerful that he can only be defeated by himself. Not even a nuclear bomb can take him out. And he can withstand the wrath of thousands and thousands and thousands of units. And his name is Chuck Norris. Chuck Norris! Guys, okay, so obviously Chuck is the best unit, right? But I'm really curious to know, does Chuck have what it takes to destroy? I don't know. I didn't even know how many units it is. How many is it? I'm curious. One Chuck. Chuck's got 1,000,000 HP, and I don't know how much damage he does. There he is. Okay, here we go. How many? 25,000. 20. Count them. 25,000 units. Okay? Does he have what it takes I don't know. Do you guys think he can? What are your thoughts? Comment below. Who do you think's gonna win? I know you'll be able to find out, but I'm curious to know how many people get it right. Let it begin. Here we go. So they're all on the same team, so they shouldn't attack anything but Chuck. And look at Chuck, he's just like, screw it. I will go for it. Oh my gosh. It's gonna be a bloodbath. I think Chuck's gonna destroy everyone. Let's see how fast, though. How fast does he kill things? He can one-hit horses. Okay? He has... Dude, look at this. Look at this mayhem. The Spartans aren't even up into the battle. They can't even get in there. Because Chuck is on the move. Chuck is on the move right now. He's just moving out. Dude, okay, I'm framing up screenshots. If you don't know what I'm doing, that's what I'm doing. Okay, here he is. Let's follow him. Look at him! So when you don't play, when you are not possessing a unit, they can punch and move at the same time. But when you possess him, you can't do it. Look at that horse is like, I got these guys, trust me. Freaking Chuck Norris. But we will possess him once. Oh my gosh. He's not gonna die. He's gonna kill every single one of these guys. He's only lost like 30,000 HP or 3,000 HP. Please. I can let this battle run. I'll come back when that 24,000 is dead. Because it's only a matter of friggin' time. Oh my gosh. I should have put the footmen and the Spartans by each other. For color's sake. Anyway, yeah, I'm gonna let this run. And just come back and see what happens. I'm gonna go eat some dinner. I'm gonna go eat some dinner, man, and come back when this is done. Well, the battle's still going. Like, I don't even know, 15 minutes later, 10 minutes later. And Chuck is still at it. He's killed 4,500 people. And his health is, he's not gonna be able to kill him. He's only killed 4,500 and he's lost like a third of his, like 2/3 of his health. Was he at? Yeah, he's at like 300,000. He's not gonna make it. He's gonna get killed. But it's now a little yin yang thing going on here. Oh my gosh. Chuck's gonna die. Okay, but Chuck is the best unit though. I mean, that's safe to say, right? It's clearly Chuck being the best unit. I wish this game was not as dark in terms of colors. It's so like ugly in terms of like the colors. You know, I got an idea. Oh yeah, there we go. That's a cool look. There we go. Kind of a weird yin yang type of thing going on. Oh yeah. Okay. Well, yeah, I think it's safe to say that Chuck's probably gonna die here, guys. He's not killing people nearly as fast as I would like. Let's see, where is he? He's just making his way all over the place. Oh, he's gonna die for sure. So, I'm gonna let it go, and we're gonna see how many he kills. And then I'll be back with the final battle. Wow! About another 10 minutes went by, and I come back, and Chuck is still alive? He's killed almost 10,000 of them! Chuck, how are you doing it? Wait a minute. He's regened? What? Dude! He cannot be killed. You cannot literally kill Chuck Norris in this game. So he ran out of his HP and then completely regened. He is the undefeatable unit. What? What? What a startling revelation. Has anybody found this out yet? I know I didn't know that. Oh my gosh. Well, guys, there is only one unit that can kill Chuck Norris. And that unit is Chuck Norris, right? It's the only person who's going to be able to do it. It's Chuck Norris, guys. Only Chuck can defeat Chuck. That's it. See, this is the only logical explanation, the only logical conclusion as to who's the best unit. The best unit is Chuck. And the best fight is Chuck versus Chuck. This is it. The showdown of the ages. Who will win? Here we go. And I knew that would happen. I don't know if you guys knew that, though. Error. Chuck Norris cannot fight Chuck Norris. Float value beyond infinity. Override of time-space continuum failed. some humor there. Well, guys, thanks so much for watching. All of you guys enjoyed this episode. Definitely make sure to leave those comments below. The game is crashed now, by the way. Hope you guys are having a great day. I'll see you in the next one.